Hello, welcome to Ollie's Garage. Today I will be diagnosing and replacing a glow plug in my Jetta TDI. Glow plugs are these little pieces right here, where when you turn your ignition to run, power is applied, which causes this end to get very hot and start to glow orange. It is extremely important that these are working, otherwise you will have difficulty starting your diesel vehicle in the winter. In my 2003, as you can see, the glow plugs are located underneath the harness right here. And in older VWs, as you can see in this picture, the glow plugs are also located in a very similar position. The harness just looks a little bit different. Let's quickly discuss diagnosis of a glow plug issue. On a vehicle like this one that has a computer installed, my first sign with the check engine light came on. I then scanned it and I could see that it complained about a glow plug issue in the number 4 cylinder. If you have an older vehicle that does not have a computer installed, then generally the issue will manifest itself when it starts getting colder outside and it doesn't start well, and then for the first few seconds of running, it runs very rough. I read the fault codes and it said there was an issue with the number 4 glow plug, which is this one right here. So that's kind of my first clue into what I'm gonna start looking at. To test the glow plug, I'm gonna remove this harness, just slowly pull on it, and be careful, it is a brittle part. You just set it aside right there. Grab yourself a multimeter and put it on the resistance meeting right here. So I have mine reading on the lowest, so the maximum indication will be 200 ohms. I'll test a good glow plug here so you can see what a good one looks like. Take a lead, ground it out, and then take the other one and just hold it to the tip of the glow plug. And what you want to see is something like this with a reading of something around 1.6 ohms to about 0.8 ohms. So this is the number 2 and you can see it's good. So let's test the number 1 just while we're at it. This one is good as well. Here I'm testing the number 4 glow plug, and as you can see, I have infinite resistance, which means there is definitely an issue with this glow plug. If you measure the resistance of all 4 glow plugs and it's nice and low, and you're still having an issue, then it's most likely your harness or potentially also the glow plug relay. And I will cover diagnosis of those components in a separate video. Make sure that you clean away all the debris that's sitting down here. If there's quite a bit, it's just hard to see on the camera. For that, I just like to use compressed air. Grab yourself a 10 millimeter deep well and crack it loose. Quick look at the one that I removed. It actually doesn't look like it's destroyed, but it was measuring an infinite resistance, so I know that this one was bad. One quick important note, VW did change these glow plugs over the years from a slow glow to a fast glow and things like that. So my rule of thumb is always when I take it out, I check the part number, and then I reinstall what was in the vehicle originally. I've got my new glow plug here, and as a good measure, I always test it first just to make sure it's not dead out of the box. All right, looks like it's working just fine. Since these glow plugs go into an aluminum block, I always like to coat these threads with anti-seize to make sure that no corrosion occurs between the aluminum block and the glow plugs. So for that, I'm just using some copper anti-seize. All right, it's nice and thick on there. Take your glow plug and slowly drop it down into the hole. Again, be careful you don't knock any dirt into it. Since the glow plug goes into an aluminum block, like I just stated, you don't want to cross-thread it. If you do that, that's no good. So to prevent that, I will start tightening it with this fuel hose. So just take some fuel hose. This is 5/16, slide it onto the glow plug. Try to keep it nice and straight, and then you can just slowly start screwing the glow plug in. Once you have it started with the fuel hose, then you can grab your socket and slowly continue to screw it in by hand. If you notice a lot of resistance and that it's difficult, that means it's most likely cross-threaded, and don't continue. Finish up the last little bit with the socket and just make it snug. Now torque it to 15 newton meters or 11 foot-pounds. Before I reinstall this harness, I'm going to grease all of these connectors with a little bit of this universal silicone grease. This should help prevent any corrosion from potentially getting in these connectors. It It's a little bit difficult, but just give it a nice dab. Reinstall this harness by sliding it over each one of the glow plugs. And then just push down on it. Make sure that they're all seated well. You should hear a little pop when you push it on. With the glow plug replaced, you can clear any codes if you had them, and then wait for a nice cold morning and start the vehicle and see if it starts better than it did before. And as always, thanks for watching another episode of Ollie's Garage.